over the top of Anderson. He's gonna get over Anderson. Tracks all the way back in. Does. And he's lobbed in! What a goal!
Inundated. So popular.
Holding me up. Now I'm strong enough for both of us. Both of us, both of us, both of us. I am a giant. Stand up on my shoulders. Tell me what you see. Cause I am a giant. We'll be breaking boulders underneath our feet.
Welcome to Court 3 at Casey Stadium for the 2019 AMNA National Championships. We're here for the men's reserves game, South Australia versus the Australian Defence Forces. My name's Steve McInnes from South Australia. I'm with Dan Cook, former South Australian, now Victorian. How are you, Dan?
Yeah, good. How are you, Steve?
Not too bad, thank you, mate. So this men's reserves grade, it's a fantastic grade. There's 9 teams in this competition, including a New Zealand team. I think we commentated a game from this
yesterday.
We did indeed. So everyone playing each other once. South Australia with just the 1 win so far, the 6 losses. ADF without a win on the board. So they'll be pretty hungry, I think, coming out for this one now. SA, who did they? They defeated ACT. So just the 1 win on the board from these 2 teams. And it was ACT that was the unfortunate recipient of that loss. So today we'll see some good fight from both these teams trying to get their first win on the board. We haven't got some starting lineups, but I can give you a hint for us. I can see the ADF guys. We've got Dish in goal shooter, Brad Teal in goal attack, Aussie in wing attack, Nelson, Joyce, Morrow, and then Josh is in goalkeeper for the ADF. The South Australian boys, can see a few of them. Adam Burford is in goal shooter, Josh Taylor in goal attack, Tom Morton in centre. Can't see too many others. Coached by Trav Burridge. They've done well, I think, for this tournament. They were a little bit depleted coming into this, losing a few players on their lead-up. We have 2 umpires as well for this game, Deanna Stainer and Amanda McLaughlin. Lisa Harm is the reserve umpire. And teams making their final preparations, heading out onto court now. ADF just entered the court, South Australia on their way out as well. So Tyson Jerry into wing attack for South Australia. Lewis is into wing defence. We've got Brock Day into goal defence. And Colby Sturges in goalkeeper for South Australia for our starting lineups. And first centre pass about to get underway now. Tealy does the first work to get himself out for that centre pass. ADF want to be nice and patient with this ball. Tom Morton up for that one from South Australia. Doesn't quite get it. Spills out over the sideline. So I believe in this division, the top 5 playing finals?
Yeah, top 5 playing finals.
Excluding New Zealand.
Yes, so looks like New Zealand will finish top of the group.
Yeah, so currently undefeated, so they'll finish top. And then I think the Victorian boys currently sitting second, only having lost to New Zealand.
Yes.
So they'll become the new number one.
That's right.
For the finals.
Beating Queensland yesterday, I think, was a tight tussle, kind of sealing that spot off after New South Wales defeated Queensland as well. And Victoria, I think, got the job done against New South Wales. So,
yep. So sitting New South Wales, Queensland sitting third and fourth, respectively, coming this ladder. Vic 2 sitting in that fifth spot. We've got Taz, ACT, and then these two teams in 8 and 9. Respectively at the moment as the ladder stands. Don't think they have another round tonight.
Final
so
game
this will be it
for everybody in the reserves competition. There was just one game today with the 9 teams, so lucky for them, a nice and easy Thursday before final start.
Absolutely. So South Australia coming up with this ball and working down the court now through Tom Morton. A little loose ball fumble there. Dish with the pickup. Was actually just commentating on the other court with his new wife. Did a very good job for her first time in commentary. Dish has been a training partner with the South Australian team, so he actually knows these boys very, very well because he's been on the training court with us. Helped out some of our tournaments as well. Played a little bit of time with my 23s along the way in his training experience. These ADF guys, unfortunately, sometimes don't get the lead up they like because they're posted all over the country, unlike our state teams, which are generally able to train together on a regular basis. So it does make their lead up a little bit trickier than the mainland states. Nevertheless, we love having them here. And they're our fantastic contributors to our competition. Tom Morton doing well in that contest just to stay nice and clean. Lots of cross-court ball from the ADF. And we see that one picked off by Brock. Brock Day does love coming outside, getting lots of picks, does a lot of work in goal defence, lots of good footwork. But ADF managed to get it back. And Burford with the chase down there. Doesn't quite get it. Keeping ADF very, very lateral here. You see all four of their players in a line at the moment with nowhere to go. Find some space now. And there we are. See Brock Day having another good challenge on that ball. Staying clean and in play. Dish finding himself way outside the circle.
So about the fourth touch of Brock Day right at the start of the match. Even though ADF up 3-0, he's had a few touches right from the start.
Long ball there going out of court. No one able to get hands on it pretty much from the throw-in. Umpire Deanna Stainer over there on the far side of the court indicating where we can restart this game from. A long look there by ADF, but maybe a mistake on that throw-in. Looks like it's going to be a foot on the line call, so will be a South Australian ball now.
It's a little bit of a coach killer.
It is indeed. Those little errors, those breaks and things like that, they really do kill you when you have possession, but they've managed to get it back. So we have another sideline throw-in over that far side of the court. And another fumble. Long look from Tom Morton all the way down into Adam Burford there, who puts that goal away and gets South Australia on the board for the first time in this game. So Bradley Teal there with the ball now, having that shot. Played 35s Australian over in New Zealand last year with myself. I was in that team with him. Good contributor.
Been around that ADF team for a really, really long time.
Has indeed. He's got a nice target in Dish in front of
does.
Him. If he can just get those holds working, Brad should be able to pull the trigger to release that ball in. Got a good bit of height on Colby. Coming up with that ball once again. South Australia having to work backwards a lot, not getting any easy looks into that circle. Adam Burford to put his second shot away, and he does. So 5 minutes played already, and we have 2-3, so just a goal a minute. Great touch there from the wing attack for the ADF. Couldn't quite stay onside though, unfortunately. Tyson Jerry having to go backwards to that reset. Josh Taylor, Tom Morton combining not as smoothly as they would like, just keeping it in. And Burford catching South Australia up three-piece now. He's shot all three of their goals. That one from a little bit further range than he probably would have liked. The other two have been nicely close under the post.
South Australia look a little bit more settled now after the start. I feel they probably rushed a few into the circle or down the court and just able to settle down and score the last three goals.
Yeah, those tips from Brock have certainly kept them in it, being the difference. Allowed South Australia a bit more possession, so they have been able to settle. It's a huge swing ball there from Adam Burford to Tom Morton in this near corner. And then all the way back across the court to Adam Burford, who misses the shot. And called for a structure there on the landing. Could have stayed clean there, might have almost got a held ball. Good to see the goal shooter's goal attacks doing lots of defensive work as well. Bit of a collision there. Brad and Colby find themselves on the floor. And ADF find themselves with another goal. 5-3 now. And a good long look into Dish. He puts that one away.
It's a nice shot on in Dish. Seems to be able to find himself in a little bit of range. Hasn't been under the post for every shot so far. So that's nice to see out of a tool.
Josh Taylor with his first shot of the game. Doesn't make a mistake. Puts that one in. 4-6 South Australia. Do you know why he's called Dish?
No.
Oh. His last name's Petri. Like a Petri dish.
Ah, lovely. So they call it's him like dish. Calling me monster.
Because your last name's Cookie.
That's that.
Some decent nicknames going around for some of these players. Everyone at this competition, of course, really, really friendly. And a lot of people now playing for multiple years get some really good friendships out of these competitions as well, across all the seven grades that we have. South Australia now patient, but lots of little fumbles and errors creeping in. So they want to make sure they clean up these connections. South Australia didn't really score every time they go down court. Nice swing to the top there. Tom Morton with the feed to Adam Burford. Puts another one in. So they almost caught this difference up. 5-6. And their centre pass. Tyson Jerick. No bit call.
Bit confused with the step, I think.
Step call, was
yeah.
it? Oh, Lewis just needed to keep his eyes up there in wing defence. Could have taken a couple of steps forward and probably had that ball. Dish now puts another one in for ADF. I was about to say South Australia then, because he's been with us so much. Not currently playing for us, unfortunately. We could probably use his height. Again, very lateral from the ADF team. There's a call all the way down court. And Dish shorts that one. Rebounds to Brock, but unfortunately footwork just finds him out of court.
Smart play from
Brad. Just throws that up into the net, so nice it touches a bit of equipment and comes on down for Dish. Pass pretty much went nowhere except straight up in the air and straight into his hands. South Australia getting forced to the sideline there. Lucky to get that ball tipped out by the ADF wing defence. Ian Joyce. And just needed to stay clean there. Tom Morton as well off balance. Josh Taylor just manages to get that one over the ring height.
Just gives the ability for South Australia just to get a little bit of a set up again into the circle instead of...
Yeah, that's right. If it was nice and clean, Tom would have been off balance, maybe delivered a bad ball. Defenders could have picked it up for them. There's some nice space finally found by Adam Burford. Drops her ball out to a very, very late drive from Josh Taylor. And finds himself with the ball again. So a couple of shooter passes there. I think the South Australian team with a clear intent to work themselves nice and close to the post so they get really high percentage scoring. Finds himself onside there, but unfortunately on that lateral pass, putting a little bit too far out for Tyson. Umpires calling time, just bring this ball back. Ever liking to waste a second, these umpires. Josh Taylor with the contact. Again, could just stay nice and clean, keep himself in play and actually put up some defensive pressure.
Yeah, I think that's probably an area that both teams could maybe
tidy up on.
See whether... No, they can just stop, allow for the flow that they're already having to kind of come through and not give away the easy penalty that just allows for everybody to set up. And, you know, they're doing some really good defensive work on stopping the ball getting straight to the circle edge.
Stepping call there. We've seen a little bit of ping pong netball. South Australia regained possession then, gave it away, threw it away over the baseline, and now we've got a stepping call on the ADF possession. So it's ball going up and back, and now... an offside call, maybe. So lots of simple errors for both these teams. Really need to try and clean that up as best as they can.
A little bit sloppy at the moment. Not.
Oh, high ball in. Brad Teal manages to get himself a shot up, but misses it. comes up with the ball as it spills out of court. Doesn't try the same trick twice. And almost eats that ball off of the tip. Sturges just losing his feet there. Good rebounds by Dish. Off balance, but puts that one in. So they extend again here. Two-goal lead, ADF. 9-7. And they have possession. So again, that discipline easy needs to penalty. Come in for South Australia. Yeah, it gives that opportunity to get that ball to the ADF, post, doesn't it?
Yeah, let's ADF reset up, especially with the tool, just an easy offload and, you know, a nice, easy goal.
Yeah, Dish is always going to win that one-on-one, you would think, with that's that right. extra height. So do what we can, stay in play, force that long-range shot.
Nice quick ball there from Tyson Jerry.
No, I don't imagine the ADF boys have that shooting percentage that, you know, the Victorians and the New South Wales players do from that kind of range. Yeah. So they're always going to want to look to get to that post, so you can leave them out there with that shot, do the double team, and then take your footwork back out to them if you really have to. There's a better straight up challenge from Sturges. Manages to get himself a tip and back into play. Tom Morton backing him up well there as well.
It's coming back in from out of court, I think, the call for South Australia. So
Dish really liking that one. Puts on some good defensive pressure.
Lovely fist pump.
Loves the fist pump as he rushes back to the post.
But that's what you want to see, goal shooters putting in the work defensively right. to then create get, the
your
turnover.
Defenders get a bit of a rest, don't they?
Yeah, that's
the,
right.
The attackers that messed it up, why not have them get it back? Shooter to shooter again. Low ball there for the big man. Gets his own rebounds and puts it away. So they extend again. South Australian centre pass, 3 goals down. And they find themselves with a minute 30 to play. ADF come through and get another pickup. South Australia regain. And Morton, Day and Jerry working really patiently. Another pass just a little bit too far away on that reset. And stepping call. So a few of those simple errors creeping in for the ADF. They've had a fair bit of possession, given a fair bit of it up just on simple mistakes, really. Burford finds himself outside the circle, swings it wide, gets it to the top now, into the last minute. Long shot. Taylor not happy with himself there, missing that shot. Goes and puts some defensive pressure on, try and get it back. South Australia really filling that transverse line now. Again, we see nice, patient ADF handling the ball a lot. Teal can't quite grab that. I think that's the second ball he's got in the face now. And Tyson Jerry just sends that ball
to the back wall.
To the back wall, exactly. 30 seconds left to play. Hopefully the ADF can get this transit down. They've now got 20 seconds, so they've wasted 10 seconds in that back third. Much quicker look there now. Dish puts it up. Doesn't come up with the goods, though, on that shot, nor the rebounds. Unfortunately, South Australia will just have a few seconds to consume on this restart. And they probably won't get it down in time. Buzzer has got to be close to going. There it is. So that is the first quarter of this men's reserves game, South Australia and ADF. We have ADF with a narrow lead, 8-11 at the break. We'll be off to some ads and back with you shortly.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back to KC Stadium, Court 3. Dan, how have you seen the first quarter here between SA and ADF?
Yeah, I think both teams have been doing the best job they probably can defensively. It's an 11-8 scoreline, so you know, not a lot of goals scored in the quarter.
Yeah, I think 19 goals in the 15 minutes.
Yeah, lots of turnovers being made, but both teams really unable to kind of capitalize on that. Probably I'd like to see them both teams slow down a little bit and maybe come forward to the ball. Just saw the ADF coach really reiterate that in their break. So it'd be nice to see both teams maybe be able to, you know, get some more goals on the board and try and convert the turnovers that they're actually creating at the moment.
Yeah, last game for these two teams. Do you expect to see changes? A few rotations, probably?
I don't know. I haven't seen much of them so far. So it's about what happens within your squad, I guess, and what it is that you're going to look to do. You know, for both teams, they're probably going into it thinking we want to go away with the most wins we can possibly go away with.
Absolutely. So, yeah, take something out of the tournament.
If we're going to start with the best teams, which I think probably both teams would have, they're going to go hard and go right to the end. So I'd say no changes. Maybe SA from winning against the result against the ACT for both teams. I'd say maybe South Australia might look at making some changes because they didn't really have the flow, or they've really got to look at slowing that movement down the court down so that they can actually convert the turnovers that they're getting.
Fantastic. Well, let's see if we can spot any changes as the ADF boys walk out onto court. All look like they have stayed how they are. Same for South Australia as far as I can see. So these two teams go at it again, see if they can make a bit of a difference. If nothing changes, we could see ADF with a nice 6-goal lead at the halftime break. Teal out for the first centre pass receive of this quarter. South Australia now trying to hold this up. Making Teal swing that ball all the way over. Dish with the strong front hold. Puts it in. Bro just holds himself down a little bit too early. Could use that height. Yeah, a lot better to his advantage.
Keep his chest up, feet grounded, you know, hips and shoulders so that it's easy to find him. Probably present a little bit better instead of the full outstretch to the ball.
See both these teams, South Australia just doing it then as well, swinging that ball right across the circle. So sometimes a little bit dangerous, but they go goal for goal. First up, so 9-12. Brad Teal with another centre pass received, doing a lot of work on the centre pass, so a bit different for a goal attack to be getting most of the centre passes. Usually like your wing attack to do that, your goal attack to have the depth on the second phase. There's contact under the post. So Dish standing himself out of play. Gives South Australia a bit more of an easy transition. They get that ball through Jerry and Taylor down to the top of the circle. Again, no options on there for Jerry. So they have to go. Now they look long. Burford off balance. Manages to put that one in as he's falling off court.
It's been better patience from this quarter from South Australia already. Though you can see them trying to bring the ball down the court a little bit simply, as we say, and
that, and they make a turnover. Exactly. Commentator's curse. Right. As soon as you open your mouth. I did that to Victoria a couple of times in that last game. I was just commentating. As soon as I said something good about their midcourt, they threw it out over the sideline almost identically both times. So it's the way we can still influence the game, even though we're retired now. Hey, Dan?
Well, yes. Theoretically retired, Steve.
That and coaching. Theoretically retired, yes.
You never know.
Yes. Yeah, I heard stories about you.
Yes.
And I found myself somehow on a playing list. Not that I've had to take court, which has been good.
It's amazing how much being retired you start to miss playing, but you also have to have the body to be able to cope with it, and that's something that I'm not sure that I will have yet.
You with the knees, me with the back.
That's right.
All the injuries for us old men. I say that at 36 years of age, of course.
Yeah, I'm
not
just
terribly old.
Just 32.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's what
you're
I'm saying
chicken
as well.
Compared to me, mate.
That's right.
So SA's centre pass here. We see the contrast there. South Australian wing attack, Jerry doing most of the centre pass receiving work so Taylor can get himself down court. Contrast to ADF. Good ball to the post there. Burford puts that one in.
The structure this quarter from South Australia really is a lot cleaner and a little bit more simply. I think Jerry's getting a little bit more angle down towards the circle edge as well.
Some strong body there from Tom Wharton, Deanna Stainer, the umpire, not having any of that. And as those boys tussle for it in the midcourt, it's actually a call offside as one of the two centres turn to chase that ball down. Brad Teal again doing the work. Dish on the rebounds, manages to just get it over the top of the South Australian defenders. Good patience now. South Australia again showing that patience. Oh, Day almost holding on to that for an eternity. Just let it go. The two South Australian players needing to talk there. Adam Burford and Josh Taylor find themselves in the same spot now. Burford finds some backspace. Keep wanting to call him Burfs. Try and keep it to his proper name. Again, Burford doing some good work for South Australia in this quarter. Oh, good long look and good solid take by Dish. Puts it in. As I say that, and I call Dish by his nickname the entire time. Generally, whatever comes to my head as quick as I can. Burford outside the circle now. Works back with Jerry. Day onto the transverse line again they go. So nice and patient. Taylor not wanting to take that mid-range shot. Puts it to the goal line for Burford, who misses the shot, but obstruction is called. And another obstruction, so both players out.
Again, some of that probably discipline that could come in, not giving away a penalty on the mid-range shot, and we saw that the goal was missed and it came back down, but just getting to retake it.
Yeah, that's right. It's just staying a player and having a good contest for those rebounds. You may as well have one player in, having go at rebounds rather than both of you standing out.
Right.
So we're back to within a goal here, 14-15. And rebounds today. Good quick release. South Australia now have the extra man in the midcourt, so should be able to work this ball down. But they have to go back, so ADF doing well to hold them up. Oh, nearly getting a tip to that one as well. Doing really well to get themselves behind the ball and slow that structure. There we go. We get a pick from the ADF. Nice clean one too. Oh, too quick on that release. ADF centre just wanting to pull that trigger straight away. Only option down court was Dish under the post, but not able to reel it in. Day again holding on to that ball for quite a while. Have a call a bit further down court. So no one scored for a little while here. We have a bit more of that, another patch of that ping pong netball where we just keep going up and down the court.
Both teams doing a lot of work defensively just to kind of stop the flow for each other down the court.
There we go. We see a shooter go the other way. Usually it's Taylor to Burford. This time Burford to Taylor. And Taylor puts it in nicely to tie this game up. And South Australia with the advantage now as they have the centre pass. So South Australia will be happy. They've pulled this 3 goals back. It's taken them about 7 minutes of this quarter to do so. They really want to make sure that they continue to have this lead. Using that transverse line really well, going back to Day quite a few times. Taylor finding a lot of body there from the ADF goalkeeper. Umpire just setting this. Amanda McLaughlin setting that in the right position. Rebounds getting tipped around by everyone. Fortunately for South Australia, Josh Taylor not able to pull that ball in low as it goes in. It goes out over the baseline. ADF finding the central corridor now. Taking a leaf out of South Australia's book and being a little bit more patient this time down court. Of course, as soon as I say that,
long ball looks straight
from,
in.
From almost the halfway line straight into Dish. Oh, another touch there by Brock Day as he goes up.
And I don't think that some of those options with the long ball straight in for the ADF are not on. It's just the execution of the pass getting into the circle, into the right space that's probably been a little bit
could just be flighted a little bit differently rather than so flat and so hard, because that gives Dish a little bit more time to move the body, get onto the right angle and take that step out and find himself probably near enough to the post to have a shot if he's feeling comfortable. Mid-range shot there from Brad Teal.
He does have a really nice smooth action, Teal.
So 17-15 ADF at the moment. South Australia won't want to waste this one. Get a nice front option there from Josh Taylor. A nice pop along the goal line as well from Adam Burford, but not used. Shot goes up and contact on those rebounds. So South Australia certainly have had their moments and they've sort of just let it go in the last couple of minutes, I feel. Dan?
Yeah, I think you're right there. Just seeing him get the ball into the circle and a couple misses from Josh Taylor probably hasn't helped the cause and allowing ADF to have a crack at taking it out to three goals.
Good straight-up challenge there from Brock inside the circle. Just the work outside the circle. Gave it to ADF, who scored another one through Brad Teal. So that was a South Australian centre pass. So ADF will extend that lead out to three, which is back where it was at the quarter-time break. And they have the centre to possibly go four up. Offside call. So a good contest outside the circle. Unfortunately, just crossing into it before the contest. Dish getting some nice elevation, going straight back to Teal. Didn't want to turn to the post and shoot that one, even though he was well and truly in range. Taylor, Jerry working well. Just not finding any angle on that drive. It's very, very... You see this sneaky
quick
little
off the post.
Ball off the post. Oh! And just rolls it over the rim to convert. That's why you want to make sure you score that goal when you do
something
like that, don't you?
That's right. It's a little bit embarrassing when those little things don't come off, or you get yourself close to the post and,
and
can't put the ball through.
Or you see someone do it from off court and the ball goes back out of court because they didn't quite get the angle right and it sprays off the post. On this occasion, though, it came off for Burford, so still just the three goals in it.
Really smart from Brad Tilden, just getting himself into position whilst returning the ball back to the penalty. It's really smart play to be able to
absolutely.
Do it.
It's all about those inches and those gains that you can make, isn't it? So every single opportunity you can get to get that ball a bit closer to the post or win that one or little one percenter is one you should definitely take. So ADF coming up with the ball here yet again. Feel that the ADF are probably just a little bit hungrier to get their first win on the board. They're converting here yet again, so that will take it out to a five-goal lead, which I think has probably been the biggest of the match so far. Got about 3 minutes 25 to play. Make that a six-goal lead if this is converted. Dish just waiting for Brock Day to stand out of play, and he does convert that goal, so... South Australia here need to make sure they just go back to something they know, something they've done in training, something that's definitely going to come off for them so they can score this goal, get settled for these last 3 minutes, maybe score one or two more in that time.
Yeah, see cross-court balls.
Cross-court balls that are hard to catch. Tom
have come back out
almost dropped that one.
Towards the end of the quarter, whereas I think at the start of the quarter when they had their roll on starting to score some more goals, it was very much angled drives and people coming towards the ball, whereas now we've kind of gone to a bit more lateral movements and pocket balls and things that aren't probably typically strong netball.
Yeah, Burford puts that one in for South Australia, so still the five-goal difference. No other games have been played for these teams, and it is their last one for the day today. So they should be reasonably fresh and able to run out this whole game, and like you say, keep those angles, keep those drives going throughout the entirety. So the more they move it laterally, the more they're going to give these nice, strong ADF bodies a chance to come out the circle or have a run through, maybe get a tip.
Yeah, just and maybe it doesn't create flow either, so it doesn't allow you to continue to keep moving the ball down the court when that ball starts to go laterally.
You see Teal with a step in there, and then the offload. Nicely to Dish. Minute 45. Oh, South Australian shoe coming off Tyson Jerry there.
Just nice little break in the
yep,
in the
hold
play
time for this.
Everybody.
Give them all a second to get a bit of a breather. Oh, he's ready to go. He's just slipped that on. That's probably why it slipped off.
Yeah, not tight enough to not stay tight on enough. Or to have to undo the shoelaces to come off.
There he goes. Taylor puts that one in from mid-range. And ADF still 5 goals up. Much better quarter from ADF. Teal not able to keep that one in. South Australia going to have to go full length of the court here and score this and then try and score that next centre pass as well. They've got a minute 10. Try and put these 2 goals on the board, this one and their centre pass, if they can. And that will see them only trailing by 3 again at the half. So it would have been an even quarter, but they've coughed it up. So I shouldn't try and predict what happens, because then it never happens. Obstruction there by Josh Taylor again. Nice to see the attackers doing that defensive work. Just could do it a little bit cleaner, if possible. Tom Morton trying to come through for that one. Can't quite get there. Gives ADF a little bit of a run. Oh. No one able to get hands cleanly on that ball for about the last 4 passes. I say passes loosely, as they're all more tips. As this ball keeps going up and back, ADF find themselves with it in their hands once again. Good long look. That's a bit of a shorter look to Dish, who puts it in from what would be mid-range for him. So South Australia finding themselves 6 goals down. So ADF have put another 3 on them. So nice and consistent from the ADF. That one drops well short. No rebounders at all for South Australia. And they fumble that one out. So 2 quarters have been almost identical. ADF winning both of them by 3 points to find themselves 6 goals in front at the halftime break, 24-18. We'll be back after a short break.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam, and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au. Sally is your local netball administrator. she receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
Welcome back to the 2019 AMNA Championships at Casey Stadium. We're on court three. I'm with Dan Cook. We're at half time now of the South Australia versus ADF 8 versus 9 game. Currently have ADF, who haven't got a win on the board in this tournament, in front by 6 goals. They've put 3 on South Australia in each of the 2 terms that we've had so far. Dan, you'll be picking a player of the match for this game.
Yeah.
It's been a fair few errors by both teams, so how are you going to go about doing that today? What are you going to look for in this back half?
It's probably been a bit of a defender's game, but I've also been pretty happy with probably what Tyson Jerry's put out onto court. I think he's kept the South Australian attack pretty well together as well. Dish has been strong in goal shooting, and Brad Teal in goal attack, you know, really controlling the front end for the defence force. So it'll be interesting to see what happens in the second half, and we can make a decision from there.
Absolutely. So South Australia finding themselves down at halftime in this game. They do have the one win on the board. They won't want to give this one up to ADF, though. So we have some changes. Jared Benbow-Agus has come on into goal attack for Josh Taylor, who has gone to the bench. And Tom Morton and the man you just mentioned, Tyson Jerry, have swapped positions from wing attack and centre, respectively. So let's see how that affects the South Australians. See if they can pull back a few of these goals this quarter, maybe a few in the last quarter as well, and get themselves back into this game. ADF, I haven't spot any changes from them. They do make it hard for us because they don't have their names on their back of their shirts, the ADF boys, but that's all right. We'll do what you can. So Jerry standing out of play. Oh, high ball into Dish with a good solid take. Day gets over it for quite a while, but Dish finishes off nicely. Good work there by Adam Burford to find himself in some space. Dishes off to Jared under the post. Puts his first goal in. New into the game.
Good confidence start
position. Absolutely. That's where you like to have your first couple from, nice and close to the post, and then extend them out after that.
Only if you don't miss the first couple.
Yeah, that's true. Otherwise, stay there. That's right. Keep shooting and
stay,
get them.
Stay in range and find a good range and have the shots from the, where you prefer it.
Dish puts another one in for ADF. Jerry having to go backwards on that centre pass, but the obstruction call on Tierley as he came through. And Burford, nice offload there. Oh, we see the chairlift from the ADF boys. Good, strong lads. Probably the ones that are able to do it, to be honest. Don't know how much extra height we got out of that. Wasn't that close to the ring, but
why not have a go?
Yeah, that's right.
It's the last game on the last day.
Yeah, have a bit of fun with it. They find themselves up anyway, so in possession, still 6 goals up. Dish making himself a bit of a target here. Manages to get that ball inbound from Tierley. And they put another one away with their centre pass. So changes for South Australia really need to start having effect pretty quickly. Otherwise, they're going to find themselves another few goals down and then possibly in the area where they won't be able to come back from it in a single quarter alone. Jared Benbolt misses that one. Good contest on rebounds from all of those boys in the circle.
Exactly what you want to see, just to try and retain the position after a missed shot is the fight for the ball while the goal was.
Absolutely. Doesn't make an error the second time round from either further, even further out. Nails it. Keeps South Australia just the 6 goals down as it was at the halftime break. And that one rolling out off of the ADF. So we've seen South Australia struggle a fair bit to go all the way down court from their defensive goal line. That ball coming into all of our cameras. We've lost picture. Hopefully you can still hear us though. We'll keep calling it for you. Nice work there from the ADF centre coming through, getting that ball all the way down to Dish in the circle. Puts another one in for the ADF. Our pitch is back and gone again. Cameraman frantically trying to plug things in and out. Producer going crazy on his computer. Jared Benbolt gets that ball at the post and puts another one away. Is the problem with things being live. Technical difficulties. Dish gets a hand on that. Oh, the South Australian boys do well to scramble. And they pick up the rebounds. ADF could have just taken their time and really settled there. They had really a 3-on-1. And South Australia managed to get that ball out of defence. So hopefully you've got the picture back now. Tom Morton and Jared Benbolt working through the midcourt there, but pulling the trigger a little bit too early on that pass to Adam Burford, who was actually leading onto the other side of the court than what the ball was thrown.
Probably a chance to slow down, turn your shoulders and look to see where Burford was running over.
Yep, of course, got 3 seconds with the ball. He pretty much threw it on about half a second, so had another 2.5 to make a good choice. Unfortunately, coughed it up. And beautiful work there from Lewis in wing defence. Manages to get that ball back for South Australia with a nice clean intercept out front. Helps out now bringing the ball down as well. Jerry with some more work. Good look to the pocket there. The driver, Morton. Burford. That ball's going to be a South Australian ball at the top of the circle though, due to the contact. So let's see if they can pop out beautifully here for Burford. And South Australia put another one in. South Australian centre pass as well, so they've closed the gap to 5. Could get this 6-goal lead down to 4 goals if they are patient enough to score this one here. Burford doing a lot of those goal line drives. And now Benbolt sweeping in through the top of the circle. Gets himself the ball right at the post. Doesn't miss from there. So 4-goal lead now. ADF. Oh, going very, very wide to a solid drive from Brad Teal. Low ball into the circle. Dish up for, doesn't even jump for rebounds. Somehow manages to still
pulls
get them.
It back in.
And puts it back in.
I'd like to see the ADF maybe look for him a little bit more. I think he's free under the post.
Nice
a couple
early.
More times. Yeah, under the post. And really easy to see. So just keeping their vision up and having a look to actually put the ball into him once they can move the defender maybe off his body a little bit with a fake or, just... looking to use the triangle a little bit better. You can see Brad Teal just put
there's
the ball into the post straight away for him. And I think he really is kind of free and asking for the ball. So if they can do that and maintain their lead.
Yeah, I think Brad Teal is probably the one to put that ball in.
That's right.
Nice and cleanly. Has a bit more experience than a few of the other lads in his lineup. So if they can get that connection working between Tealy and Dish, should find themselves in good stead. Long ball over the top. South Australia doing a lot of that. Managing to get it back to the post now after that chase down by Adam Burford. And Jared Benbolt new into the game puts another one in.
It's been done a great job since coming on, I think. Really helped the attack line. Kind of scored 6 of the 7 goals so far. Doing a lot of work on the outside of the circle and inside the circle to kind of create the space as well for himself.
That's right. It gives ADF something else to think about.
That's
when
right.
Taylor wasn't doing a lot of the shooting and Burford was doing most of it. So it can just double down on Burford and try and cut that ball off. And now they've got something else to think about because Burford's not doing the shooting. And Jared Benbolt instead is doing all of the shooting. So forcing them to change up a little bit. 4-goal lead, ADF. Yeah, replay call there. Just had enough control of it to probably take it the first time and didn't. So See this ball getting nice and sweaty. These boys do sweat a lot. It's quite humid in here. Long look there from Jerry to the pocket in Morton. Day. Ben Bolt works again. That one coming off Adam Burford's hands in the close contest. So ADF now get the chance to go full court. See if they can score. Good space found there by the wing defence. Dish comes up with the ball. ADF now doing a bit more swinging than they probably needed to again. Could have just stood up and delivered that ball to the post. But they get it there now through Brad Teal. Puts that one away. South Australian centre pass. Ben Bolt has been good, doing a lot of ball handling outside the circle as well. We've seen a lot of late drives in from him.
Really just controlling the front end for South Australia at the moment. Ben Bolt.
Yeah, he's been the difference in this quarter for South Australia. Cleaned up their play a fair bit. Unfortunately, hasn't caught up very many goals for them though. Just caught up the two goals so far. 5 minutes 45 in this quarter left to play. Dish gets his own rebounds. He's trying to get his stats up a little bit maybe in this last game.
That's right, but just as I was saying before, I think the ball into Dish is probably there fairly early, and that ball went in straight away from Brad Teal. So
ADF come up with that that centre pass of South Australia's. So, oh, good tips there. Great tips from the two South Australian defenders. Managed to get it away, and they help drive it down court. Got options on both sides of the court here now, does Jerry. Uses the far side. And I believe that's an out-of-court call. No whistle being blown for out of court now, so sometimes the boys don't know that they have to stop because the umpire just has to point. So sometimes it can be a little bit confusing now if they think they managed to save it and the umpire doesn't think that they did. Patient again through Brad Teal at the top. Oh, ADF wide out to the pocket. Jerry collects a fair bit of body there.
Still going for the contest. Slowing the
play Always down. Going for the contest, yeah. And unfortunately, hands up too soon for Sturges. And they put another goal in. Centre pass for ADF. 4 minutes 10. And another simple error from ADF. So we've seen a few less simple errors, though, I think, this quarter than That's we right. did probably in the first half. So being some cleaner netball. SA having to go all the way back to the goalkeeper, finding themselves very lateral. Now getting a bit of depth through Jared Benbolt. Perfect out the top of the circle. Looks to the goal line. Doesn't get it. Jared Benbolt a little bit annoyed that that wasn't called his way. Ball running well over onto court number four. Should be back in a second. Here we are for restart. Oh, Berth has a good go at that. ADF all along this transverse line.
Really good contest. Causing the turnover.
Yeah, they're the long balls you want to contest as well.
Yeah, forcing wing attack into a flat drive, which really means that wing defence is inside in the contest and gets to have a goal at the ball. And if you can get a tip to it, it comes off the attacker. Turnover.
Yeah, and because the ball's so long as well, you've got a lot of time to make that choice and get your footwork there and get in front and affect that spoil. So South Australia keeping ADF all the way down that sideline, and ADF boys not able to keep that one in. So just as we said, the skills have been good. We've had a few more errors start to creep in. Was a bit of a slippery part of the court once again. Straight up contest that player didn't recover very well from because they didn't have any feet underneath them. They get the ball to Ben Bolt at the post. He's missed that one.
It was a good structure, a nice hold though from him to kind of get the ball in the space that he did, but yeah. Not being the tallest in the circle.
Yeah, a good first contested rebound there from Burford, who puts the shot in after another miss, getting his rebounding stats up as well. Uncontested on the second rebound. So South Australian boys finding themselves a lot of time in this same pocket. Saw four of them there. Just a little bit of a glimpse of the game on the other court in the background as well. We're in court four, South Australia ACT and mixed reserves. Burford now, mid-range shot, misses that. Tom Morton comes up with the rebounds on the circle edge. And good offload by Burford to Ben Bolt at the post. You think this one will probably go in. Minute 30 on the board in this third quarter. That one does certainly go in. So, four-goal lead. ADF, centre pass.
South Australia probably just looking for one more turnover just to try and close the gap a little bit more, make that last quarter really interesting.
Absolutely. You gotta have the attitude when you go out there that anything a team does to you, you can hopefully do back to them, as long as you're alert and wise to what they're doing to you. These ADF boys throwing absolutely everything. So we see Brad Till run all the way down to the far goal line, around the side of the court. Good little no look pass, and there's that chairlift. That time they get ring height. Umpire says
on the way
you
down.
Deflected that ball on the way down.
That's right.
Which you cannot do, no matter if you're being lifted or jumping up yourself. Got to get that ball on its upward trajectory, so generally out of the hands is a better place to go.
A chance to bring it back to two for South Australia.
Unfortunately, they mess it up. I didn't see what that call was.
No, I missed that one as a breaking.
Break
possibly.
Contact call there. So, in the last minute, good touch there from
Day.
From Day. Till unusually taking the throw in. Wouldn't usually have a goal attack take a throw in from that position on court.
He does have the control in that front end for them, though, so.
Everyone's a little bit confused.
It looks like the siren's gone off and from court four, and everyone's thought it's this this court. So
that was our siren, though, and unfortunately Brad Till not able to finish that one off. So we have at three quarter time break South Australia 30 versus ADF 33. We'll be back in a few moments.
Sally is your local netball administrator. She receives daily messages from her umpires on her phone and Facebook. Mary just messaged, and Craig, Sam, and Jane. Struggling with managing umpire rosters like Sally? The Time Umpire software allows you to take control with ease. Check out timeumpire.com.au.
To the men's reserve, South Australia versus ADF on court three here at Casey Stadium for the 2019 MNA National Championships. Saw South Australia fight back quite hard in that that quarter to get this six-goal deficit down to a three-goal deficit, which is where it sat at the first quarter time break. So, Dan, what do you expect from this last quarter?
Look, this is the last quarter for both teams for the week, so I'd expect that there's going to be no love lost, and it's probably going to jump up a level and we'll see what happens. So, yeah, looking forward to it to see if South Australia can get themselves back into the lead. Probably thought they might have a chance at snaring a second win for the week. So, we'll look to see how it goes. And you know, ADF I think will be really up for the challenge to score their first.
Yeah, absolutely. We have seen some South Australian changes. We have Yui Tomo going into wing attack for Tom Morton, who is coming off. So, the last instructions coming from the ADF coach. We can overhear them. They are really, really keen to get this win on the board. South Australia as well, up and about. Those boys have worked hard for quite a long lead up, so they'll really want to go put the, at least win this quarter. If they can't win the game, at least win this quarter. Trying to get it back to one or two goals. See them now in their final huddle.
And Steve, what do you think of the changes? South Australia trying for the win here?
I haven't actually seen Yui play this week at all, to be honest. Not because he hasn't played or anything, just because I simply haven't been around enough. Yeah. I've been off doing commentary and coaching my 23s and all sorts of other things, keeping me busy, as you know, Dan. More a wing defence.
Okay.
A really good wing defence. He's one of those guys that just gets in there, has a contest at everything.
Digs around and does the job a wing defence should do.
That's right. Is for his personality, knowing him, is uncharacteristically annoying on court, okay. If you know what I mean.
Sure.
So, yeah, interesting to see him come into wing attack, but that's all right. Let's see how we go. Maybe he's been playing that a bit more this time round. Was one of the most improved South Australian players last year at his first tournament, so second time round, and see what impact he can make at wing tack. He also got himself a new nickname this week. The clothing supplier that we used spelt his name wrong.
Okay.
So he's now called Tomo
instead
of Tomo. And I think that's actually only by me, but we'll see if we can make it stick. There we go, Tomo with his first ball. Doesn't place that one quite correctly. Going to have another go from the sideline here. Again, South Australia having to go right across that circle and right back to where they started with it. And that quick flick, shooter, not coming off. Ben Bolt to Burford. ADF need a balance here. They're all around the ball. They need to get some space. I think that was probably a step there. If not, that one was.
And South Australia probably want to keep it simple. I think last one slightly on the flashy side, the nice little flick pass just wasn't to where the shooter was, and maybe just trying to keep it really simple and making sure that the goal's scored, because they want to get back into the game and have a win.
Yeah, absolutely. There we go. Shooter. This time it comes off. And South Australia do score. So they find themselves down a goal. They've already cut two back. Appealing for the hell ball there, but Tomo obstructing. South Australia just needing to clean up that body work now. 2-on-1, unfortunately, with Day standing out. And Teal puts that one away. Tomo to Ben Bolt. Oh, Burf sprays that one. Was trying to go to Jerry in the pocket, but put it behind him. You and I complaining about our age. I can see in the background there a man named Steve Barndan playing for South Australia.
Yes.
At 55 odd years old.
Yes.
And you and I sitting here in our mid-30s complaining about how old we are.
Yeah.
Playing over there on the mixed reserves for South Australia.
Steve's been around for a very long time.
He has indeed. His son also plays.
All right.
As well for South Australia. ADF here looking long to dish down that baseline. Not many options to go to though after that point. Teal injecting himself through the top. And another contact call off the ball on Sturges this time. So Teal, you imagine, would look to the post, knowing that you've got Dish there to take some rebounds, and he does, and he misses, but that's all right.
It's all right when you've got
Dish,
the tool to
the big
pull
man,
the ball in.
Yep, gets those rebounds for him, puts it away.
Just what you need is a confident shot when you've got a tall goaler to steal it if you miss.
Some nice footwork there along the goal line from Burford. pops out again on the other side. So working a lot of passes here, South Australia, to score every goal because they're getting it right to the post. And
got towering the ball. Not towering the court.
The court, maybe.
No cameo from anyone.
No, players doing it themselves. Usually you see an umpire or a trainer or someone run out. And the restart now. ADF again. Teal gets another ball. Contact call outside the circle. So again, another 2-on-1. So you could hear the ADF coach yelling, hold him, hold him, hold him on that 2-on-1. As it is, they missed a shot. So South Australia. Oh, unfortunately, give that ball away. Some good
straight
hands
away
there from Dish. Uses those long arms to get himself a nice defensive touch.
That's the second intercept that he's picked up today. So defensive pressure from the shooter can really help, and look, it could result in their first win.
Yeah, error there from South Australia too on that centre pass.
Great hold.
Good ball to the post. Bang, puts another one in. So Dish and the ADF team scoring the last few goals here. And long look from Teal. Doesn't quite get there. Didn't have the elevation that time. South Australia now going to want to do better on this throw-in than they did on the last one. Ah, no, and they've messed that one up as well. A stepping call there on Brock Day. Gives ADF the ball. Teal decides to go out. Another contact call. Unfortunately, just coming from behind there. So will he look to the post this time? Looks a little bounce pass.
He probably would have gone high on that one to the tool.
Yeah, absolutely.
But instead of making him bend over to catch the ball.
Not listening to his coach, because
nope.
We heard her say that
go high
a few minutes
go
ago when we were at our break. Go high.
Put the ball up to him.
Don't make the big man bend down all the way to ground and get that.
Don't put it up to him when there's two on him.
Burford along that goal line. He's done a lot of damage along there. Converted a lot of goals. Still got a smile on his face. Been a long week for these boys. 8 minutes 55 of their campaigns left. They really want to make sure they play as hard as they can for those last 8 minutes. Ooh, very close to a help ball there. Good hands around there from Brock Day. Gets himself an intercept. Ben Bolt throws that one away. It's going to be an offside call though, unfortunately, on that landing. Find a little bit more shooter work working well for them. Obstruction call, goal in. So 36-38. South Australia can get within one if they score this centre pass. Tomo takes a long while to get rid of that. Draws Burford out of the circle. Nice and patient through Jerry. Tries to go across that circle to the drive from Ben Bolt. Gets picked off. And ADF pop that ball up. They're the ones you want to have a run at, South Australia. Anytime that ball goes high down the line, and that's one Brock comes out and picks up. He's done really well. Get himself out to that ball. They go all the way back to the line. A couple of first ball gives that probably could have been given rather than going all the way back. South Australia probably a little too quick to go back to that transverse line. They've lost that ball here, so ADF looking for something. Takes a while to come. And they've called it an offensive call there. Or a stepping call? No, he will be standing out. Umpire just making sure. Amanda McLaughlin there, making sure we're in the right spot for that penalty. So South Australia with a chance here to take it to within a goal, 37-38. ADF will be getting a bit nervous now. They've had the lead for a lot of this game.
I think the nerves from experience will be raging on both sides.
Yeah, absolutely. South Australia having only the one win as well. Neither team really has that know-how-to-win sort of experience. And when the game's this close, that can really come into play, can't it?
Yeah, it really can. And I don't think it matters whether you've won every game for the week or you haven't won a game as the ADF. One-goal games. It's always nerve-wracking.
Yeah, so this is the closest ADF have got to anyone. They lost to Queensland 64-27, lost to Vic 1 68-31, lost to Taz 51-22, lost to New South 62-30, lost to Vic 2 54-39, lost to New Zealand 82-28, and lost to ACT 33-26. So they'll be pretty happy with where they're sitting at the moment. Two goals up, have scored 39 goals, which is equal highest. That's what they scored in the game against Victoria 2. Scored 39 goals, but lost that game. 39 goals now and currently winning the game. So they'd be real keen to keep that up. Oh, just throwing it up and hoping. Sturges had to go on two hands and pulled that in. Would have been a better option as it is. ADF just managed to retain possession. 5 minutes 10 on the clock. Jerry pulled for the contact. ADF now again with the big guy under the post. Expect Tealy to take a shot. He does. Puts that away. So that was a South Australian centre pass. The ADF scored. Extend this out to three again. Tealy gets himself out. Tomo gets a good touch. Unfortunately, can't get all the way to it and save it. Running out of room, going offside as well. So, umpire Dino Stainer setting us in the right spot. Risky high ball to Tealy. And then he dribbles it underneath his feet. Unfortunately, didn't pick that up with the strongest of hands. Jerry looks long into Burford. Just outside the circle edge. Turns back to the pocket. Oh, ADF come up with that ball. Oh, and just managed to keep it in the third.
And you can see Brad Tyrrell just really called the centre to come towards him. And I think that helped them keep possession just then.
Tomo gets another tip.
Jerry making a contest of the ball.
Oh, two ADF boys just needing to talk there. Oh, Dish puts that one through.
Confidence from the big man.
Yeah, absolutely. Is that going to influence your picking of your player of the match, Dan?
I've already made a decision, I think, already. But, we'll see what the last 3 minutes goes, just in case South Australia maybe pull back over the line. But
Ben Bolt missing that shot. That was a crucial moment there, I think, for South Australia. They really needed to score that one. Jerry with a good hard ball get on ground level. Gives them the chance to go back and score. Has to do the work at the top of the circle as well. See Burford and Ben Bolt both in the same space a lot of the time at the moment. It's causing a bit of trouble for South Australia, but they managed to get the goal. 2 minutes 48. ADF putting in that long ball.
That Dish calling for it. No, they've had a look in this quarter as well. I think they've probably only let one sail out over the back. And you know, it's something I said earlier is that he's on early.
Yeah, I think they want to free. They probably want to try and score and as quick as possible. Keep that scoreboard pressure on the South Australians. Full goal lead now to the ADF. Burford again doing a lot of work out of that circle. He's encouraged a lot of rotation between himself and Ben Bolt. Just not clean enough with those swing balls and with the triangles, the South Australians. The ADF bench right up and about. I can hear them through our headphones and through our commentary. They are quite loud. They are quite keen for this win.
Very keen. Asking the defenders to move their feet at the moment, I think, just to try and get around and not give South Australia an easy shot at goal.
Good hold over that ball, but Burford puts it in over the hand. Minute 44 to go in this game.
Yeah, a step call there against the defence force.
So this is where the ADF boys really need to make sure they're nice and clean with every possession they get. They've still got a decent lead. Oh, and it's a replay call on Burford there. So if ADF can just hang on to this ball for a bit of time, score this goal.
A little bit of smart time wasting there, I think.
Yep,
from absolutely. The defence. So let's put the ball down.
Yep, take a while to take that.
A couple
pass.
Of seconds. Oh.
Tierley, as he goes out of court, flicks that back in. Several times now on the refeed. Again, a little bit more time running off the clock. In the last minute now. Dish uses the post to try and keep himself balanced. Not allowed to put the ball in the post though, unfortunately. Or your body. As a long high ball out gives the ADF boys chance to take a bit more time off the clock by sending it out of court. Tomo in the game. South Australia just trying to rush now, which unfortunately you can't do even if the time is against you. Cannot be very long left. I think you'll hear the ADF guys erupt if they win this game. And it looks like they are going to good high ball into the post, and Dish puts in another one.
ADF really listened to their coach this quarter, putting the ball in high, not the flat ball that they've been putting in before, the low balls they've been putting in previously.
Burfs with the last shot of the game. Does not count. So at the end of the game, we have ADF taking out a win. Their first win of the tournament, 43 to South Australia, 39. Both teams ending up on one win for the tournament and finishing in 8th and 9th place. Dan will be back on court with an interview with his player of the match. I don't know who it is, so prepare to be surprised. We'll see you guys soon. Thanks.
We're back at Casey Stadium with the player of the match, and it's Dish. Dish, how was the game? First win? How's it going?
Yeah, first win. I think it was a really good win, a really solid team effort. We've been building throughout the carnival. We've been really looking forward to this last game against SA. It was a real hard game. It was just good to get over the line in the end.
And a close one really going into the last quarter. What was it the coach said to you guys that really kind of got you there?
Yeah, so we had that lead at three-quarter time there. So the coach really just talked about controlling the tempo of the game, playing into our style and not letting our heads get run away so that we could just control the game and keep chipping away and keep that lead.
Congratulations on your first win and well done for the tournament.
Thank you very much.
I would be nothing.
to get over the top of Anderson.
He's going to get over Anderson.
Tracks all the way back in. He does. And he's lobbed in for Warragul!